Hello children, I am Mamta Sinha and today I am going to take your science of class 3, that is chapter 1. The name of the chapter is, you all can see, living and non-living things. Ready? Okay. There are many things around us. They all are of different types. Some of these things are living and some are non-living. Plants, animals, human beings are living things, whereas rocks, rivers, tables, chairs are non-living things. All man-made things are non-living things. Learn about the features of living and non-living things. Children, you can see here, these are living things and these are the non-living things. Living things can be differentiated from non-living things based on their features. What are they? They are living things breed, they move on their own, they grow, they need food, they feel and they reproduce. And what about non-living things? Non-living things do not breathe, they do not move on their own, they do not grow, they don't need food, they do not feel and they do not reproduce. Now we will talk about living things breathe. Children, you can see, all living things breathe. They need air to breathe. You all breathe. How do you breathe? We take in air and we give out air. This is the most important feature of a living thing, that all living things breathe and we all need air to breathe. How do we breathe? This is our nose. Human beings breathe through their nose. And there are many living things on the earth. How do they breathe? Fish breathe through gills. They have gills and they breathe through their gills. And children, you know, insects have tiny holes in their body. They are called spiracles. And they breathe through these spiracles. How do the plants breathe? Plants breathe through tiny openings called stomata. And these stomatas are present underneath the leaves. They are present under the leaf. They are tiny holes through which air goes in. And that is the way the plants breathe. And we all know that non-living things, they do not breathe. Now the next feature is, living things can move. See, here is a picture where a boy is running, this girl is walking, and this little chap is jumping. And this small tortoise is crawling, and the fish is swimming. These all are showing, and the bird is flying here, you all can see. We can know that living things can move. Animals move from one place to another. Why do they move? They move in search of food, water, and shelter. How do the human beings move? They move by using their legs. And birds, they use their wings to fly. You all know that they move from one place to another in search of shelter, food, and a good place to live, the weather conditions and all, and they use their wings to fly. And how do the fish move? Fish move with their fins. Plants are living things, but they do not move. They do not move from one place to another, but they are living things. Why don't they move? They don't move because they are fixed to a place with the help of roots. They have roots, and roots go inside the soil and they are fixed there. That is why plants do not move, but they are living things. Non-living things do not move on their own. But you will ask, fan is moving. Isn't it a living thing? Fan is moving because we have moved it. We have switched on the plug switch and it started moving. The non-living things move when some living things move them. They don't move on their own. Remember this. Non-living things never move on their own. They can only be moved when you will move it. Next is living things grow. Can you see this picture here? The size of living things changes as time goes by. You can see a baby which has taken birth grows and grows into an adult after some years. Animal, a small kitten, it has grown and it has become a cat after some days. And a baby plant, it has grown from a seed. This baby plant or the seedling has grown into a small plant, then into a huge tree. You all can see, this all shows that living things grow. All living things grow with the passing of time. A baby grows into an adult. A caterpillar grows and becomes a beautiful butterfly. A tadpole grows into a frog. A kitten grows into a cat. A puppy grows into a dog. And as I have said you earlier, a seed grows into a seedling and then into a plant. Okay, children, understood? It's very interesting, isn't it? Living and non-living things we should know. And living things have a lifespan. Lifespan means what? Lifespan means all living things have a certain time for living on this earth. All living things live up to a certain age called lifespan, and the lifespan of all living things is different. Children, do you know a dog lives for 10 to 12 years, and a butterfly lives for around 20 to 30 days, and human beings live for 70, 80, 90 years, and trees live for many years, maybe hundreds of years. This is called a lifespan, the time which they live in. That is called a time lifespan. Okay? And non-living things, they do not grow and they do not have any lifespan. They can live for many years, they don't need to grow. They are man-made things and they may be God-made things, but there is no lifespan. They do not grow. Okay? Now next. Next is, living things need food. Children, what have you eaten today? You have taken your breakfast, you have done your, have you had your lunch? Okay, that means living things need food. Why do you need food? If you don't need food, what will happen? You will not be energetic and you will feel very low. Why? Because food gives us energy to live and to grow. All the living things in this world need food to live and grow. Plants can prepare their own food with the help of air, water, and sunlight. And how do they prepare food? The green leaves of the plants, they are the food factories of the plants. They are the kitchen of the plant. And the process by which plant prepares food with the help of air, sunlight and water. It is called photosynthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means to make. In the presence of light, when the plant prepares its own food, it is called photosynthesis. Animals cannot make their own food. Human beings, we cannot make, we only cook the food. We only bring the raw materials from the market and we cook in the kitchen. Those raw materials are made by the plants. We cannot make our own food. Animals cannot make their own food. They get their food from plants or other animals. You know that? That human beings, either they eat plant products or animal products. They can't prepare their own food. They only cook their food. And on the other hand, the non-living things, they do not need food for anything. Next. Now, living things can feel. Children, have you ever seen your mother cooking food? Have you ever observed her making tea? Go and help her. And when the tea starts boiling, if you touch the lid of that kettle, what happens? You just move back. Why? Because the lid was so hot. That means with the help of your skin, you can feel that heat. All living things can feel the changes around them. Human beings, we are human beings. We feel the change through our sense organs. And you all know that we have 5 sense organs. What are they? First of all, we have ear to hear, eyes to see, nose to smell, tongue to taste, and skin to touch. And you all know that the skin is the largest body organ and it covers the whole body and it helps us in touching and feeling it is hot or cold or what is the nature of that object. And you know about some insects, how do they feel? Butterflies, grasshoppers, cockroaches and many insects have a special body part present on their heads and it is called antenna. They feel changes around them with the help of that antenna. The antenna of the insects help them to find their food. They can smell and taste with the help of their antenna. Tigers and dogs have a good sense of hearing and smelling. You know, dogs are the best friend of the police. Why? Because they can smell and they can remember the smell and they help the policemen in catching the thieves. So they are the best friends of the policemen. And the birds, falcons and eagles and hawks, they have such a good eyesight that they can see the prey from very far away. They are flying high up in the air, but on the ground, if any rat is moving, they will see from there and they will just swoop down and catch that rat and then again fly away. Have you ever seen that? Yes. In the break time when you eat the samosas from the canteen, what happens? Sometimes the eagle comes and they take your samosas and fly away. They were flying high up in the air, but they saw that samosa in your hand from there. Why? Because the eyesight is very, very sharp. Cats have whiskers like mustache They have whiskers to feel movement around them. Plants do not have any sense organs, but they can feel the change around them. For example, there is a plant, Touch Me Not, or the mimosa plant. When you go near it and touch the leaves, closes itself. Sunflower. You all have seen sunflower. And have you seen that it moves the sunflower, the face of the sunflower moves according to the direction of the sun. Haven't you seen? If you have not seen, go and see. Very interesting. And we all know non-living things do not feel the changes around them. This TV, it is not feeling any change. It is just like that. The non-living things, they do not feel any change. Now children, next is living things reproduce. This is also very important feature of the living thing. What is reproduce? What is reproduction? First, we should know that the process by which living things produce more of their kind is called reproduction. You are the baby of your parents. You look like them. They have reproduced you. The baby cat, have you seen kitten? The baby of a cat. It just looks like the cat. The cat has reproduced that. It is called reproduction. When a living thing produces its same kind, it is called reproduction. And this is a very important feature of a living thing. And some living things reproduce by giving birth to their young ones. And some others, they reproduce by laying eggs. Animals such as fish, snakes, frogs and lizards reproduce by laying eggs. You can see in this picture, fish lays eggs and small fishes are coming. Hen has laid egg, the egg hatches and a chick has come out. Father and mother, they are giving birth to a baby. Children, some living things reproduce by giving birth to their babies and some reproduce by laying eggs. Animals such as fish, snakes, frogs and lizards, they reproduce by laying eggs. Birds such as hens, parrots and ducks, they reproduce by laying eggs. What happens to the egg? You saw in the picture, after few days the eggs hatch and the young ones come out. They are called hatchlings. And animals which are mammals such as deer, lions, cows and human beings, we give birth to their young ones. You have taken birth by your parents. You're the same kind. You look like your parents, aren't you? Don't you look like your parent? Yes. Plants reproduce in different ways. Most plants reproduce through seeds that grow into new plants. Some plants grow by stem cutting. Children, now as we have finished the chapter, we will go through the differences between the living and the non-living things. As you can see, the first difference is living things need food, air and water, whereas the non-living things, they do not need food, air and water. Second is living things grow, whereas non-living things do not grow. Third is living things can move on their own, but non-living things cannot move on their own. Fourth is living things reproduce, but non-living things do not reproduce. Living things have a definite lifespan, whereas non-living things do not have a definite lifespan. Sixth, living organism excrete. That means we sweat, go for urinating yourself, that is excretion. But non-living things, they do not excrete. Example of living things are human beings, plants and animals. Example of non-living things are books, pencils, mountains, rivers, sky, and all the man-made things around you. So children, this was your chapter. Have a nice day. Have a nice time. Thank you, children.